All right, so the final element we want to look at is mood. And mood refers to the atmosphere the composer intended to create around the piece of music that they composed. All right, so is it a dark mood? Is it a happy mood? Is it scary? But really want to watch out for the kind of words we use. We don't just want to use low-level words like, oh, it's happy, oh, it's sad, oh, it sounds angry, oh, it sounds bad. Bad isn't even a mood. You can't say bad or good. You want it to be as descriptive as you can. So try and say magical. It sounds enchanting. It sounds adventurous. It sounds lively. It sounds grim. It sounds dark. It sounds haunting. It sounds devastating. So you want to be able to have those different kinds of very descriptive words to really get into the mood of the piece that we're talking about. So there's a huge amount of words you can use, but you can't say bad, good. Bad, good does not refer to a mood, okay? You can say happy, sad, but those are still very low-level words. Let's try and amp it up and use as many descriptive words as we can. So let's listen to our first piece. Grab your headphones and let's see the mood. Let's try and decipher the moods of these pieces. All right, so our first piece is by Mozart. Let's hear it. So right there, I would say it sounds very jovial, very cheerful, very merry, very uplifting, just very, very happy, very happy. Happy, but don't use happy. That happy is the general word. Let's be specific with the words. Let's go to our next one by Erik Satie. So right there, the mood is more contemplative, more pensive. It sounds like he's really thinking about something. So I'd say contemplative, suspenseful, pensive. Pensive means you're in thought. So that's how I'd describe the mood for that one. Any other words that you have? Remember, they're fully valid as long as they're a mood and not bad, good. All right, let's hear our next one, some Viking music. So right there, very tense. You can feel the tension. It sounds kind of terrifying, like something's about to happen. So I'd say very tense, very terrifying as the mood for that one. Right there, very playful, very cheerful, very merry, very uplifting, very bright. Bright can also count as a mood. So that's how I describe that one. So right there, I'd say very regal, very elegant, very merry, but has a very royal feel to it. So I'd say very regal, very refined sounding. Sounds very dark. Sounds like I'm being chased, like I'm being pursued. So I'd say it's very threatening, very distressing, very, it's a grim situation. Those are some good words to describe the mood. Very happy, very uplifting, very bright, very merry. That's how I'd describe it. When I wake up in the morning, love. Very mellow, very relaxing kind of mood. It puts you in a calm state, but very mellow, very relaxing.
I heard that you're settled down, that you found a girl and you're married now. I heard that your dreams came true. Guess she gave you things.
All right, so right there, very nostalgic, very somber. Has a bit of like a sad feel to it. So I'd say nostalgic, somber. Nostalgic because they're remembering something from long ago. So that's the kind of mood I describe to it. All right, and those are our different moods for music. I'm gonna put up a table that has a huge amount of words just so you can look at. Obviously not gonna remember all of them, just the same way you don't know all the words in the English language, but try and pick up on some. Try and rememberize. That means try and remember what you memorized from looking at these words, all right? Pick out some that you like, some that you feel like, oh, I haven't heard that before. Or it's like, oh yeah, I know that one. But try and pick up some of them so that you can really be able to describe mood well. All right, and that right there are our moods. So we want to use those descriptive words. We don't want to use words like, oh, it sounds nice, it sounds all right, it sounds bad, it sounds good, it sounds low, it sounds deep, it sounds high. Those are not words to describe mood. They would be better suited for describing timbre, saying deep, high, low, bright, all right? Bright can also count as a mood, but good, bad doesn't count as anything. So make sure you really get those. And altogether, those are our different aspects. Those are the timbres of the different musical instruments. Those are the textures of how instruments are when they come together, and the mood, the overall atmosphere that the composer is trying to create. When you write a story, you want to know, oh, is it going to be happy, is it going to be sad? And it doesn't have to remain with one theme, one mood the entire way through. The mood can fluctuate. It's up to the discretion of the composer. He can do whatever he wants because he's the one who's creating it, all right? So I hope you had fun listening to some of those, and make sure you revisit them so that you can really have these ideas stuck in your head. You can be able to decipher things without me having to prompt things out of you, all right? So hope you've had fun understanding, and I can't wait to see how well you've understood these things. Bye for now.